Hi friend, this is At The Rate, I Old Monk, and today I am with the TCL Pride 500L. So this is the model number of the device. One of the cool features that it gives you eye unlock. So we are going to do the review and complete show you how the eye unlock works. So let me show you here. So as right now it is searching my eyes, and I will go to that, and as you can see it is scanning and it just gets open. So this is a how there is no fingerprint and it opens just in a few seconds. So this is one of the cool features used by the device, and I definitely like it. The price point of the device is 10,490, which is a good price, and according to the screen. So let me go through the hardware specs of the device. So once we go to the hardware specs, let me go through that. It comes with running Android 5.0.12 Lollipop. It is running on 8 cores, it's octa-core processor. It has a full HD display. It comes with a 13 megapixel at the back. In the front, it has a 5 megapixel camera. Let me 8 megapixel camera, as you can see. Sorry for the 5 megapixel. And other than that, it has 2GB of RAM. It comes with the 16GB of internal storage. Other than that, it is having a Qualcomm processor. Overall, the device looks good in hand. The 5-inch display. And let me check out the number of multi-touch here. So, as you can see, it comes with the 5 multi-touch, which is great according to the device. And as I have already opened the Antutu, let's go to the score of the device. So the Antutu score comes around 30,000, which is very good according to me, with the octa-core processor, and the device gives a great offering. It doesn't hang much, it offers a great speed. Working is very easily. So let me go through the quadrant benchmark test. So for the quadrant benchmark test of the device, it comes around 21,822. So this is the 21,800 something. So quadrant benchmark is good of the device. Other than that, we will go to the photos, camera and the pictures, what it takes. So I have taken and used the device for few days, and definitely I like the camera. The camera performance of the device is good. Here, as you can see, this is a normal camera, not in DSLR. So here you can see nothing, but as far as I zoom, you can see the camera quality in pixels. You can see the building very clearly with the color combination. So this is one of the great things which I loved. Here you can see everything is coming very clearly and proper. I am not seeing because it is sunset. Now this is the normal camera view of the device. It is offering a great color combination, little bit fuzzy. And here I have tried to take a macro shot, which didn't came out well. And as you can see, a close shot of didn't came little well, but overall, yes, the camera shot is good. The front camera is good. It doesn't come with too much self beautification mode, which I don't like really from my side. Other than that, let me go through the camera first. So in the camera, we get very, very less manual things. So as you can see here, we are getting the auto mode, the HDR mode, the panorama mode, the manual mode, and time lapse, scanner, face beauty. So let me go to the manual mode here. In the manual mode, as you can see, it takes the picture. Due to the settings, we go. So here we can adjust the ISO, the shutter speed, the focal length, and the WB. So these are the things which can be adjusted here. Now I am putting it into the auto mode. As far as we go to the auto mode, one thing I like about the camera, as you can see, the focal point comes very soon. The focus of the device is very pretty good. It takes the focus very fastly. So this is one of the cool features. The front camera is also good in the device. Other than that, the device offers a good display. The sound and the audio quality is good. For the audio, I will test you the YouTube thing. So for video, we will go for the YouTube, as I already told you. So in the YouTube, I will show a normal video. Let's hope there is no advertisement in here. So I have to skip that advertisement in a few seconds. So now here we skip that, and now I'm putting the volume in the highest. So the video has a little distortion. I will skip this one. I will go to the another one where a video. So you can hear the video quality is really good. The sound and display, the offering of the device is very good. One of the key features, the audio is good. The call quality of the smartphone is good. The phone is very light. It is not heavy in use. And now we will go to the gaming of the device. So now we will see the gaming of the device. It is a 4G smartphone and definitely works the 4G very well. There is no network issue problem. The call quality is good. The audio output is decent, and the earphone performs good. I will say not too good, but okay. So the output is not too loud. Here, as you can see, I am just putting the audio. It is loud enough to listen, and now I am putting it little down as I want to show you the game graphics. And as you can see, the graphics of the device is awesome and decent. It has a 2GB of RAM, which lets you feel there is no hang or lag here. And as you can see, so I am in a driver mode, and certainly as you can see, the device performs very well in the graphics quality. There is no frame drop regarding the gaming. So as far as the concern, the gaming and the graphics of the device is very good. So at last we come to the battery, and the battery is nearly 3000, which works good here. As you can see, I have opened a lot of apps, but it opens very easily, and as you can see, it doesn't take a lot of time to open. So as you can see, this is one of the key features of the octa-core processor. So the battery lasts around 1 day overall. So this is all about TCL Pride 500L. This is @IOldMonk signing off. Please like the video, share the video, and subscribe to our channel.